¿Qué tal, mi gente? Bienvenidos a otro episodio de Mi Mundo. Si no estás suscrito a mi canal aún, me gustaría invitarte a mi comunidad. Hit that subscribe button for me, please. Hoy estamos aquí con la famosa Stephanie Stepherless. ¿Cómo prefieres que te llamen? Stepherless.
Yes.
Para los que no saben, Stepherless también es una artista y hace poemas eróticas, ¿verdad? Eróticas
y... No solamente, hay otra.
¿De qué se trata de tu trabajo?
En verdad, las cosas de la vida, tú sabes. Me encanta hablar de cosas como relaciones, como cosas que pasan, que son dolorosas. Porque hay cosas en la vida que uno no se quiere hablar, tú sabes. Y es una cosa que no duele a uno. So yo quiero hablar de eso y hacer que la persona, como se dice en inglés, se dice healing.
Healing, yes.
I want people to heal.
So, we're gonna get straight to the point
now. Okay, let's get it, let's jump right in.
Let's go. Let me ask you something. So, being Afro-Latina, do you feel like you have to choose side or like people don't accept you on one side from the other? Like, what do they normally tell you?
Absolutely. I feel like I'm too black for the Spanish people and too Spanish for the black people. So it's like my culture will look at me and say, "You're not Puerto Rican. You ain't Puerto Rican, and you need to stop claiming Puerto Rico because you're not."
So the other day I was on Stepherless Instagram, and there was this one guy that I saw posted like a nasty comment about you. When I saw the comment, I was like so surprised, man. I was like, yo, like he went in as Stepherless. So what was that all about?
So kind of like the same thing that I was just saying. He was like, you know, they had declamar la isla, and I was like, well, I was raised in this tradition. Yeah. So do I just come at this person and I give them facts and say, well, you know, you're black too, you know? But then I was like, these people, like I went into his profile and it was just like,
so
no
he was,
picture.
He was Puerto Rican, you don't know who it is.
I don't know who it is, but it seemed personal. So I'm like, well, if you made that Insta for me, thank you. I appreciate you taking the time out of your day to do that for me. I appreciate that, that makes me important.
Yeah.
But I think that person was Puerto Rican as well, just because of the way his profile was. So I approached it in a laughing way. Like I said a little quote from a famous salsa song to like show you, hey, like I got the culture in me, but I'm not gonna sit here and denounce another side of me because I embrace all aspects of my culture. You get what I'm saying?
Let me ask you, have you ever been to Puerto Rico?
Yes.
Many times?
Not many times, but I have been to my island. I want to go back soon to volunteer and do my part to repair my island because it's suffering, too much suffering.
What about, how did you get to learn the Spanish language? Because was you born in Puerto Rico or was you born over here?
I was born in the Bronx, in New York City. The way that I learned Spanish is from my parents and my grandparents. That's the primary language that they would speak, is Spanish. And then, well, not primary, but it was almost like equal. It was equal English, equal Spanish. You get somebody mad though, Spanish is coming out.
Did you had like any struggle that you remember like learning the Spanish language or anything?
No, because it was just so natural. Like we had Univision on, and it was like, you know, vete pa allá, limpia eso. Like it was just very natural because this is the language that's being spoken around me. So, you know, and I'm growing up with it, so.
I get what you're saying. So, I know you have a son as well. Does your son speak any Spanish or is you showing him, like, how is that going?
Okay, so he knows Spanish songs that he probably shouldn't know, but but that's how I introduced the culture to him. Is that, you know, yo cocino arroz con gandules. Él está ahí conmigo y yo le estoy, you know, explicando las cosas. And I'll tell him, you know, what this is what we eat.
Okay.
And then the music element of it as well, introducing him to the music so he can hear the words in Spanish.
So do you hear him like saying words in Spanish or anything?
Yes, just when he's singing, because it's like it's or he'll be like Dios te bendiga, mami.
Oh, bendiciones.
Because every night I tell pide la bendición, because that is something that is, you know, it's a matter of respect in Spanish speaking cultures, Caribbean cultures, if anything, you have to ask for blessings.
Is there anyone in your family that don't speak the Spanish language that you know of?
Yeah, there are people who understand more than they speak.
Okay, then.
You know what I'm saying? And so now, as far as like teaching my son, there are little sticky notes all around my house. Like I'll have mesa on my table. I'll have microondas on my microwave. I'll have horno on the oven. So he's going around and he's seeing these words, and it's not only showing him what the words are, but it's also showing him how to spell it.
I actually like your tactics, because the way like when I speak Spanish to my kids, them, you know what I'm saying, like I would give them like instructions and they would know some of them, and the other way like I would use like some flashcards and I make my kids then compete against each other, you know, because they are so competitive,
right? So it's fun.
Yes, but I also like,
and I saw your video too.
I appreciate
that. Was very entertaining. His kids are very competitive. You need to see that video.
Hey, but check it out.
Go check it out.
And I actually like the way you like put that just now. That gave me an idea also of how to like teach my kids them, you know what I'm saying? Like maybe I might just wanna put a sticker on myself saying sofa, you know what I'm saying? So that's so that's something that I'm definitely gonna like try and put in order as well. For someone that is that like a Spanish parents, what would you recommend to them other than that perfect example that you just gave, like for them to teach them kids Spanish as well?
Okay. So like for instance, like if you want to say go, you know, brush your teeth, but de la, you know, la boca,
the body language.
Or vamos a comer, quiere comer, you know what I'm saying? Or like tienes sed, or you know, tiene que ir para el baño, and you're pointing to the bathroom. So you're using your hands. That's another reason.
Basic, like body language.
We use our hands a lot because we're trying to get you to understand what we're feeling with our hands, because we want to express ourselves a little more than just with our words. So I'll point to something and he's like, oh, okay. You know, mom, you know, I'm cold or tengo frío. Okay, well, you know, that's there. Yeah. La sábana. Ponte la sábana. And I'll just like, ponte, you know, ponte la sábana.
I like that as well. I use some of it. I use some of it, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes I would like try to see and let my kids them like guess and see like where they at, and if I see them struggle, then I will point it out to them.
Yes,
you know,
so
what
they can try to get it out for themselves, you know, to get an idea of what the language is.
Do you have any fear of your son not speaking the language, growing up and not speaking the Spanish language?
Absolutely. I mean, a major fear in my family is diluting the culture. You know, we come from amazing people who did amazing things, and already our history has been taken from us.
Yes.
So the only way that our things can essentially live on is if we introduce these things to our children, because they're going to carry it on to their children and so on and so forth. So it is imperative that we have a sense of identity, because if we know where we come from, then we know where we're going.
Exactly. I like that. In my family, for example, like my sister, you know, she have a Nicaraguan parent and she have a Puerto Rican parent, but she don't know either one of the culture.
Oh, that's
you good. Get me? And for you guys, man, if you all haven't watched that video yet, man, I'ma leave a link up top so you all can check it out. It's about my sister saying how she feel not being connected to her own culture, you know. So that's something that I've been trying to work on as well, and we got a little something planned for her. Have you always considered yourself Afro-Latina?
Honestly, no. And that's because I wasn't pushed into that train of thought until I saw that I wasn't being fully accepted for the Puerto Rican people. And it honestly was crazy to me, because I always had an attraction to the culture.
The Spanish culture.
And even Afrobeats. I listen to Afrobeats. I've always had a pull towards Africa. And I never understood why. It's just one of those things where it's like, okay, this is probably where
you belong.
This is homeland for me as well, and that's okay. You know, for a lot of people, like much like yourself, it's like people want to make us choose, but we can have multiple homes.
Yeah.
We can have multiple places where we pull.
Like I said, we can have best of both worlds.
Yes, absolutely. And they just mad. They don't got all of this flavor. It's okay. You know? But at the end of the day, it's a beautiful thing that I did find that I was a part of this subculture, because now I have a place for myself. you know what I'm saying? But okay, Afro-Latina, so I can get the best of both.
Yes.
And embrace them equally, because I don't love one more than the other. Just because, you know, I speak Spanish or I cook, you know, Puerto Rican food, there's not one that I love more. I love them both equally. They make me who I am.
That's dope, man. That's dope.
You know, but it's crazy because that could also do to the fact of the whole identity crisis that we all essentially have as being, you know, Afro-Latinos or just African in general, because of our culture being taken from us, of our knowledge, because we have all these books that say this is what happened, right? But in these books, it's like white people are always winning. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Where are our stories? Where are the remarkable things that people of color have done? You get what I'm saying? And if we grow up not seeing that, we think that we're not remarkable people, even though genetically we're dominant. You get what That's I'm saying? Crazy. So it's like, how do we go from there?
This is a question that I want to ask you. Have there ever been a time where maybe not, I don't know, for you or anyone of your family member weird and didn't want you guys to date outside of your race?
I was very fortunate to grow up, on my mother's side, I was very fortunate to grow up in a very open-minded household. Shout out to moms, because you're the best. I love you, mommy! But she is just so amazing because she's not like your average, you know, parent, to where they get older and they get stuck in their ways and they don't want to be open-minded to other things. Now, granted, her concern with me diluting my culture is real. She does not want that to happen. She wants my child to be present, you know, in that sense. But she is all for love.
Okay.
Whatever my heart. Now, on other sides of my family, which I probably just won't mention the areas, but if y'all see this, you know who you are. They have said, oh, you know, are you dating a black boy?
So then feel some type of way about you dating like, a black person.
Because to them, it's like an emergency. You know what I'm saying? In their mind, it's like, whoa, like, you're supposed to be with another Puerto Rican. And it necessarily doesn't even have to be black. It could be white, or it could be, I mean, even like, Pakistani. Like, it just cannot be anyone other than Puerto Rican, because that would then dilute. But then again, we are diluted because we're mixed.
We're all mixed, man.
So it doesn't make any sense to me. Like.
So, what do you think about people that call themselves Hispanics but don't speak the language and most likely don't know anything about the culture?
Oh,
what do you think about that?
I know it's funny that you say most likely don't know, because I was going to say, are they aware of their culture at least?
Yes.
Honestly, part of me just want to just consider them to be white, like, you know, because they'll fall in line with the privilege. They'll see, okay, my skin is this, my skin is that, I don't speak this, I'm going to be considered this, so I'm going to go in with that and I'm going to take advantage of, you know. But it's hard to say, because it's like, what are you if you don't have culture?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? If there ain't no season in that pot, is it going to taste good?
So, for real, so you saying at least they need to know one or the other.
Yeah, I mean, like, if you don't speak Spanish and you're well cultured, like, you understand where you come from, and okay, you can call yourself a Hispanic, you're this, you're that, your parents, you know, may have had some influence in music, in food, in tradition, anything like that. But if you're just completely unaware, then you gotta figure out where you come from.
So to all of you people out there, man, if you calling yourself Hispanic, Afro-Latino, Afro-Latina, anything that got to do with our culture, man, at least know something.
It's time.
Because you just can't be calling yourself Latino out there around the place. And when people ask you, like, what part you from, or where your people from, or what is your place favorite food, or whatever the case may be, man, you have to know something to be consider Afro-Latino. That's my personal opinion as well to them. Yeah. Speak the language or know your roots. Yeah. Easy as that. If you don't know either one, then go figure something out.
Right. It's like you want to be a part of the chess club, but you don't know nothing about chess.
To be honest, you can't talk about something that you don't know then, because then you would only be gossiping.
Yeah.
And we don't do gossiping one time. So anyway, guys, This is Steph Earless. I'ma leave her Instagram and her YouTube as well right down below, so you guys can go and check her out, man. Show her some love. Please. And some appreciation, man. Steph, thanks a lot for coming on this show, man. It was so dope. Like, every time I hang out with you is a lot of knowledge, and I learn something new from you every single time. And because this is like personal question that we never discuss as well too, you know. I think we all have something to give and we all have something to learn from each other as well too, you know. So guys, thanks for watching, man. I hope you guys like this video. Make sure you all go on like my Facebook page as well. Steph Earless have a Facebook page as well. I'ma leave that down below also. Go and check me out at NikaFlow505 on Facebook and aka NikaFlow505 on Instagram, man. Hit a thumbs up to this video if you like it. No thumbs down, we don't
no,
do that.
We don't like that.
No thumbs down. So and also, man, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Oh, don't forget to also hit that notification bell, man, so yes, you can stay updated for every time I post a new video. You get me? And any suggestions, any questions or anything, feel free to comment down below. You don't know. Salute from the general.
Life too fly to be stressing. Throw trouble away and take your blessing. Every day is a new lesson. I'm not perfect, but I am progressing. Always shoot my shot, they step up, then I fade away.